Hi guys, this is a black 2015 HSV VF Clubsport R8. This car is for sale. So, it's got your HSV body kit. It's got your old school halogen headlights, LED daytime running lights, front fog lights. It's got your front parking sensors. It's phantom black. Headlights have silver and black treatment. It's got your 20-inch Rapier forged alloy wheels in stainless steel. They were an option. Tyres have stacks of tread left in them. It's got your HSV 4-piston AP Racing Brembo brakes in red. And here are your rotors. I don't know the mill of the rotors, but I'll link it in the description below. Pitch black fender vents and mirror scalps. It's got your antenna, not the shark fin one, unfortunately. Proximity keys, which I'll get to in a minute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10-way electric passenger seat. It's got your sill plates, HSV carpet mats. Hey, decent sized glove box. HSV embroidery there. Your Alcantara. Just lower my seat a bit. Interior is a really nice place to be. It's got that black ice air freshener, as you can see. Your Alcantara door locks. Your piano black finish here. So that's your central lock-in. Your carbon fiber dash spears. Your Bose sound system. Hard plastics here not only feel good, but look premium. Got your leather seats with a bit of Alcantara. I apologise for the noise nearby. I'll just move that seat forward a bit. I have decent amount of room in the back. Two map pockets. Flip down center armrest, but no cup holders. It's got your suede trim on all four door panels, well, door cards. Here's the lever, an Alcantara. Rear air vents in the back. Get out this side, the child lock was on. I was lucky. Fuel cap, as you can see. You don't have to open it from the inside of the car, you can just open it by pressing it. Tow ball, wanna put a tow ball on a V8. Quad exhaust outlets, which you'll hear when I start this up in a minute. 340 kilowatts of power. I'll get more to that soon. Got your HSV wraparound tail lights. Your Sasson graphite rear spoiler. Move into the boot. And you've got 495 litres of boot space. And some net and a net for your for loose stuff. Your temporary spare wheel, not a matching one, unfortunately. HSV logo and your R8's logo. HSV, I just want one sticker. Now, going round. So, your second alloy wheel, there it is there, has stacks of tread left in the tyres. HSV logo in the tail lights. Yep, there it is. Don't know if you can see, but it's gosset. Promise it's gosset. Third alloy wheel. Stacks of tread left in the tyres. And finally, your fourth alloy wheel. And again, that's got stacks of tread left in the tyres. Now it's got your Clubsport badging on both the back doors. Now we move to the engine bay, and that's where stuff gets exciting. Here is the heart and soul of the VF Clubby. This is the 6.2 litre LS3 V8 engine, and wow, what a monster. That engine creates 340 kilowatts of power and 570 newton-meters of torque. Got your OTR cold air intake. Don't think it's had any other mods done. Built in the old Holden factory at Elizabeth in February 15. HSV plates, always got to mention that. This is bill number 1825, and it's phantom black, and it was finished as a HSV on the 24th of February 2015. Black engine cover, as you can see. HSV logo. Now we start. 10-way electric passenger seat, your carpet mats, alloy face pedals, so that's them there. Now, you are about to hear this car. Just get my seats right first. So, to start it, you put your foot on the brake and press that button. I'll stay quiet so you can hear it. That's the sound of it. I'll give it a few revs soon so you can hear it. I'll let my engine warm up a bit first. So, on this side, it's got your heads up display controls, automatic headlights, no button to switch on the fog lights. So that's it there, moving my seat forward. Around here, it's got your blind spot alert. It's got your electric mirrors, your central locking so you can lock the car. So this is your heads up display, and I don't know if you can see it because of the sun. So this one tells you your speed, your degrees outside, and what gear you're in, and G-force as well. And back to main menu. So move my seat back a bit. Get the kilometers up for you. So it's telling me that the car's low on fuel. So, I'm in sport mode. still telling me won't show the kilometres. So it's telling me to put my seat belt on. This tells you your speed. So it's got Bluetooth with enhanced voice control. And indicators come up on the heads up display as well. Build quality is good. Source, volume. And this side, it's got your forward collision, your so lane departure warning, forward collision alert. Got your airbags galore, this car. Power steering, it's a little bit vague. Lever wrapped steering wheel. I'll turn it off until it's time to show the infotainment system. It's got your cruise control. 6-speed automatic transmission. Your R8 logo. I'll move that out of the way. So that's it there. It's got your electronic parking brake. Automatic park assist. So this car parks itself. You can also turn your rear parking sensors off. Now, this car's got lumbar support. I've just adjusted it so it's more comfortable. It's got just two decent sized cup holders. Key charger, which I'll show you right now. You can slot your key in there and it charges your key. So that's good if you have a flat battery. USB plug, AUX, and a 12 volt socket. It's got your piano black and chrome finish throughout the cabin. And more carbon fiber spears here. Your brush aluminium here. 6-speed automatic transmission, which is lever wrapped. It's got your paddle shifters as well. I'm ready to move to the infotainment system, so I'll start the car again. Here's the service sticker. Not due until 95,000 kilometers or August this year. So get to the EDI later. Navigation. I really apologize for the sun, so voice control doesn't always work for me, so I'll give it one go.
Please say a command.
Destination.
Please wait until after the beep to speak.
Destination.
Please say a navigation command or say help.
Address.
Say the destination address.
Brisbane Road.
I found multiple results. 4, Grant Road, Mullet, South Australia, say 1. 4, Rose Road, Burbridge, Western Australia, say 2. 4, Rose Road, Lomond, Queensland, say 3. You can also select your choice from the list.
3.
Now driving to Rose Road, Lomond, Queensland.
So, calculating the route.
The route has been calculated. Please follow the highlighted route to your destination.
So
please turn right on Cross Street.
It comes up on the heads up display as well. So it'll take 260 kilometers to get there, and I wouldn't get there until 13 minutes past 7. I can't drive because I'm 16 and don't have my learners yet. You can also go destination. You can cancel the route. Let's do that. So address entry, points of interest, previous destinations. address book, phone book, selects from map, my home, favourite routes, travel guide, and this one too. So there's all the destinations that were keyed into this navigation system in the past. Selects from map, my home. There's lots. So there's points of interest. Go home. Config. Now playing Bluetooth. It's got iPod and USB integration. Phone AM, FM. Pandora, which is no longer available in Australia. Stitcher, DVD, but there's no DVD player up in the roof. USB and AUX, like I said, via AUX, tone messages, quick info. Now, here comes this bit, enhanced driver interface. So, your brake and acceleration, and it tells you what RPM you are at, so I'll touch the throttle a little bit. So that responded. It tells you what gear you are in. Question. Power and torque. Transmission temperature. Elevation. Exhaust pressure. I'll touch that throttle a little bit. Air intake temperature, manifold air press, oil temperature, power. This one's on torque, so I'll touch the throttle a tiny little bit. So it responds. What else is there? Fuel economy. So this car uses around 12.7 litres per 100 kilometres. Stopwatch, you can start. You can stop. Race, you can even go to your own racetrack. So that's custom one, custom two, custom three. Custom 4, custom 5, 6. So, Bargallow Raceway in Perth. So, give you a listen to it. It won't work. Barksville Raceway, Hobart, Tasmania. Broadford's Track, Victoria. Quarter Park Raceway, Melbourne, Victoria. Collie Motorplex WA, so that's in Western Australia. Eastern Creek Circuit Raceway, Sydney, New South Wales. Hidden Valley, Northern Territory, and it's in Darwin. Lakeside Park in Brisbane, so we're in Gympie, Queensland, so we're less than 500 kilometres away. MALLALA Motorsports Park, South Australia. Morgan Park Raceway out at Warwick, Victoria. So I think it's between Ipswich and Toowoomba. And Mount Panorama Bathurst, where the V8 supercars go to race and do 1,000 kilometres, and they have co-drivers for it. Phillip Island Grand Prix Circuit, Victoria. Queensland Raceway, Ipswich, Victoria. So, I'm in Queensland. So three race tracks in Queensland that are less than 500 kilometres away from Gympie, Queensland, where I am. Sound Down Raceway, Melbourne, Victoria. Simmons Plains Launceston, Tasmania. Wakefield Park, Goulburn, New South Wales. Winton Motorway, so Winton Motor Raceway, Victoria. And back to the start. It's got a 9-speaker Bose Premium Audio, which I'll show you right now. You can see.
So please smile, I know she must be kind. In her eyes, she goes with me to a blossom world. I'm picking up good vibrations. She give me excitations.
Got your tilt and telescopic steering wheel, your R8 logo, and gauges here for oil temperature. So this one's oil temperature and battery voltage. Here is your CD player. No CD, and there's no longer CDs available as well. Dual zone electronic climate control. So my passenger is on 18 and I'm on low. You can adjust your direction of air and fan speed as well. So there it is there. As you can see, comes up on the MyLink infotainment system. It tells, and it looks good as well. Your chrome air vent surroundings tells you the time outside and the degrees outside. Vanity mirrors, map reading lights. As you can see, so traction control. I'll turn the music down now. Traction control. Make sure that's turned off. So there's no light coming up to say it's turned off. Nope, not coming up. One important thing, and it's very important. This car is a performance car. And in a performance car, you must turn traction control off in a performance car like this one. So, here's the key, so it's lock and unlock. The boot button, remote starts, which I'll get to in a minute, and a panic alarm. Flip key, show the LED daytime running lights and tail lights. Here are your LED daytime running lights, as you can see. So that's them there. switch over LED tail lights real quick. Don't think they're on. No, they're not. The exhaust has that nice deep rumble to it without it being too noisy. Now the engine's warmed up a bit. I'll give it a few revs, then I'll shut it off. So, the back of the exhaust. So I'm about to give it a few revs, then I'll be shutting this off. So that's the sound of the exhaust. I'll shut this off now. And want to show you something if I leave the key inside. Watch. So when I leave the key inside, it beeps at me. And it flashes and it says reminder, it says remote left in vehicle. So now to the remote engine start system. So you press the lock button twice, it beeps, hold this button in, and it starts up. So that's the sound of that exhaust system, and here are your LED tail lights. Now once you have done the remote start, you climb in. An odometer is 88,195. Remote start done, so all you do is press this button and you're on your way. The car is fully on. So you can make the car quiet too. So it's quiet. I'll just give you a quick demonstration. So that's tour mode, sport mode, performance mode. So that was a demonstration. Try one more time turning the traction control off too. Nope, not going to work. I really hope you enjoyed this review, and this is Jordan's Car Reviews, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel and tap the notification bell, and please also like and share the video, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.